You already know, if you've looked at my videos before, I've had this generator out to repair it. Now, my starter's gone out on it, and I got to remove it, because there's no way you can get to the starter with it installed. And the funny thing is, it looks like it's on slides, but it would not fit through this hole right here. I don't get it. Oh well, got my floor jack ready. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 4 in the back. And that bracket right there, I mean, you know, for my exhaust right there. All right, guess I'll start doing it, because I sure as heck can't get to the starter with it right here. So let's get on with it. All right, easy part's done. Got the exhaust on. Now, two there, and 4 in the back, couple wires, and I'll go ahead and get this thing lowered. So before you start messing with the wires going to the generator, you wanna disconnect the batteries here. Not the batteries for your starter on your engine. My batteries are in the stairs going up inside. You definitely want to disconnect these batteries and then have at it with your electrical wiring down there. All right, I got all the bolts out. The fuel line, all the electrical. The bolts are out. It's just being held up by my floor jack. So, let's see, go easy. Might not come down evenly, I'm not sure. I'm exactly in the middle. Oop. All right. Might need two hands for this. Not sure. I could videotape it, but you get the gist of it. All right, so I'm gonna lower it and get it out. Can't even breathe. Oh man, that was crazy. That's where she goes. Ground wire, couple wires, fuel line, and she's out. All right, now take the cover off and get to the starter. All right, the cover's off. Just held on by 4 of those right there, 1 in each corner. Now I gotta remove this cover right here, because, actually the starter's right here. I don't know what I'm talking about. All right, so let's try it. All right, starter went right there. There it is, it's out. I'm gonna, I'm gonna ops check it. We'll see. I don't know. It wasn't turning this thing over. But let's check it out. Great thing about having a electric golf cart, you got all kinds of batteries. But I disconnected it from all the rest of the batteries. So I just got 1 12-volt battery here. And I'm gonna check this starter out. But I gotta put this down, because I gotta hold the starter or it'll just wanna jump right off the golf cart. Maybe I can bring it a little closer. It's gonna be just a little spark, but at least I could see if the starter works, which it does. That sucks. It ain't the starter. So now I gotta troubleshoot what is going on. I ordered a solenoid. We'll have to put the starter back on and try it manually like this. Well, we know the starter works, so, but it wasn't turning my generator over, so let's go troubleshoot. Yay! All right, so starter's back on. Starter's back on. Now, let's see. If you're afraid of a little spark, well, obviously, it ain't the starter. I ordered a new solenoid too. Right there, brand new. It better not be that solenoid. That's gonna tick me off. All right, one step at a time. Now, I hook the wire back up. It goes over here. It goes down to the solenoid. So, let's see what happens now. Whoa. Well, we know the wire's good. Oh, if I got a bad solenoid, I'm gonna be upset because you can change the solenoid out while it's installed. Maybe I should have did a little troubleshooting before I yanked the sucker, but if you're like me, I like to have it out in the open. I can't be on my knees. I'm too old for that. Whew. I don't even like it sitting down there. All right. So we know the wire's good. We know the starter's good. Now ye old solenoid. Ooh, doggy. Well, I got my solenoid hooked up, got fuel. I don't know what in the world was going on, but you think that was gonna do that in the camper? No! So what did I do? Pull this for nothing? Talk about some troubleshooting. Oh my God. That's one of those things that makes you go, hmm. What is going on? Well, as you can see, it is running. So that was loads of fun. And I didn't find anything wrong. Maybe there was a loose ground. I don't know. That was sure a lot of work to find out there's nothing wrong with your generator. The hard part, getting her back in. All right, well, You've seen the video of getting a sucker back in. I gotta push it up under there and then get the floor jack up under there, because I can't have it on the floor jack at the same time because there's just no room. No room. I hate you people for designing it like this. This whole thing should slide right out and make it easy. Oh well. Let's see what happens when I get her in. Alright. Here goes nothing. Ah, that sucker's heavy. Ow! Such a tight fit, it's not even funny. That's the easy part. Now, to get the floor jack up under it. That's the hard part. Alright. I gotta take a rest. Well, it's in. I spared you the cussing. And discussing more cussing than anything, putting that sucker in. Yep, just a couple cuts there, couple cuts there. Oh, I'm getting too old for this crap. Yeah, let's buy a camper, good idea. Well, I don't know how many hours it took. A good maybe 4 or 5. Let's see what happens. I already primed it. Well, that was fun. I don't know what was going on, but I didn't change not a single part. Go figure. Didn't change a single part. Maybe there was a wire loose. I don't know. I first thought it was my solenoid. Ordered a solenoid. Put it on. No love. But you hear it. It's going. It's not quite all the way done yet. Alright. Got the battery all hooked up. Let's see if it starts from inside. Oh, it started right up. Now, let's put a load on it. Don't mind the camper. Let's see. We want it on cool. So we'll put a load on it. Well, the microwave didn't come on yet, so I know something. Oh, there it is. There's the load, too. See how she sounds like she's doing all right? I think it took me like 4 hours to get that thing out and get it back in and troubleshoot everything that I thought was bad but was good. So there must have just been a loose wire. What a bummer.